This is video number 6 on chapter 3 current electricity of classical physics. Kirchhoff's rules. Junction rule. Junction is a meeting point of two or more branches in a circuit. This is a junction point where 6 branches are meeting. Junction rule states the sum of currents entering the junction should be equal to the sum of currents leaving it. So in this junction, the currents entering are I1, I2, I4 and I5. So I1 plus I2 plus I4 plus I5 should be equal to the currents leaving are I3 and I6. So equal to I3 plus I6. So sum of currents entering the junction should be equal to sum of currents leaving it. This is based on the fact that the charge is conserved, and when the flow is steady, there cannot be accumulation of charge at any point in the circuit. So whatever charge is entering this point should leave. Now let's discuss the loop rule. Loop is any closed path in a circuit. In the below circuit, there are 3 loops. This is closed path 1. So this is loop 1. This is loop number 2. And this is loop 3. So the loop rule states that the algebraic sum of changes in potential around any closed loop should be 0. The change in potential can either be a potential rise or a potential drop. In a cell, there is a drop from positive terminal to negative terminal. This is a voltage source. This can be considered as a cell. So in this direction, there is a voltage rise because we are going from negative terminal to positive terminal. And in this direction, there is a drop. We are going from positive terminal to negative terminal. In a resistor, there is a drop along the direction of current, and there is a potential rise in the direction opposite to the current. So in this resistance, there is current I1 flowing in this direction. So in this direction, there is a drop of 4 into I1. And in this direction, there is a rise 4 into I1. So in this resistor 2 ohms, I3 is flowing in this direction. So in this direction, there is a drop of 2I3. Let us consider an example. So this is the junction. So at this junction, the currents entering is I3 and the currents leaving are I1 and I2. So if we use the junction rule at point A, we get I3 equal to I1 plus I2. Now let us consider one loop AHDCBA. That is this loop AHDCBA, and apply the loop rule, that is summation of drops equal to 0. So I1 is flowing in this direction. So along this direction, there is a drop of 30 I1. So 30 I1, and this is the direction of the loop. So from here to here, there is a rise. So it's negative because we are taking summation of drops. So minus 45, there is a rise of 45. And the current I3 is flowing in this direction. So there is a drop here. So plus I3. And here there is a drop here, 40 I3. So 40 I3 equal to 0.